second to go ahead and accept that into the minutes. Motion by Jason, second by Brad, all in favor? We have any other new business, Sherry?
Judge, I do. Marlene, the priest sent me this for the, it's the resolution for the health department for their tax rates that were set, that we approved setting. But this is a new form that the state requires, so she's needing this put in the minutes. It really should have been done in July, but she failed to put this in, and it is a new form. It's not changing anything of what you all approved, it's still the 2.6 and still the 3.0. So we're still, the tax rate is the same, it's just a form that needs to go in the minutes.
All right, we just make a motion and a second for to approve the new form into the minutes. Motion by Curtis, second by Brad, all in favor? Any opposed? All right. Clay, you want?
Yes, Judge, thank you. The last time the fiscal court had approved, we had met with a different companies regarding the expansion on the jail, and we had approved the judge to sign off on the architectural contract. Now, since that time, it's a very involved contract, it's something I had to take time to look through and to look at the numbers and make some comparisons. We have been in contact with them, and I have to say, we're working very well with them. We've had a good meeting with them in discussing several different aspects. And one thing that I wanted to do when we have this contract, I want to make sure that we've got the appropriate language in there that protects the county, obviously. And the contract that they use is with the American Institute of Architects. It's basically a national contract. It's a contract form because this company actually has in fact contracts over the nation. I have had an opportunity to review similar program or similar expansion or building of a jail where they had a contract with Rowan County. And the reason why that's important is because they are, there's different terms that we need to have in the contract, and then you've already authorized the judge and the jailer to sign it, but I need to make you all aware because it's very important. For example, one provision in the contract is, let's say that there is a dispute over a matter, and you know, we're not satisfied with something, or we don't feel that something was done appropriate. The first step in that would be what's called mediation, where the parties would have to go to non-binding third party and dispute their differences. That's a standard provision in this contract, and that's something I would suggest that we go along with. If that breaks down, then we have an option of do we go into arbitration or are we allowed to litigate the matter? Again, those are provisions that are important because if you all tell me that you want to choose the arbitration route, you need to understand that means that we're letting a third party make a binding decision on who's right and who's wrong. Now, in my opinion, and in the Rowan County contract, they opted for the litigation route. Now, nobody is wanting litigation. That's not the point. The point is we want to ensure that if we are aggrieved, that we can go through the appropriate remedies. So that was one of the big things, and I'm going to suggest to you all that we opt for the litigation route if things break down, because there will be provisions that there's nothing wrong with arbitration, but once that's locked in, that's it. You're done. As opposed to having the whole case fleshed out in the court of law, which is where I feel like anything major would need to be done. So we have that issue. We have certain provisions regarding professional liability. If they mess up in the Rowan contract, they had a $5 million policy limit, which I feel like was appropriate given the size of the project. They have a $15 million umbrella, which would cover any other forms of, they have automobile liability, they have work comp coverage. So basically, I'm just wanting to let you all know because I don't want to have this contract signed, something fall through or something happen, and then you're not, we're not made aware of what's going on. So those were the major issues I wanted to kind of address with you, and I'll be happy to answer any questions. The only thing that I didn't like in the Rowan contract that we're going to nail down is in their contract, they had anticipated date and construction schedule, and they left it to be determined. I'm not going to leave that to be determined. We need to have a good faith date along with provisions, and you can recall, I recall the specific question being asked about penalties if things aren't done on time. Again, we don't want them to, we don't want to pay a penny in penalty. That's not the point. The point is to make sure that this project moves forward in a timely manner. We had snow. You're down for a week. We understand that, but there's ways you can build that into the contract. So that's something I would suggest strongly, that we try to put in these good faith dates and numbers. And they told us verbally what they felt like they could do, but we have to get it locked down on a contract. So that would be the only major exception I would have to this other contract. So I just wanted to kind of go over those, and I'll be happy to address anything in particular if anybody has any particular questions. But mainly, I think we need, in the Rowan contract, I don't know if I already mentioned it, theirs was a $14 million, ours is around 11.2. So they're comparable size contracts, and the coverage that we're going to be afforded, they're pretty much in line, I guess. And everything else in the contract, to me, looked appropriate. So if y'all have any specific, if you all have any specific questions, I'll address them. But I just want to make sure that we're all on the same page, because when the judge signs the contract, it's going to be a binding contract. So it's just important to me, because this is obviously something we want to have all of that to know how to go with these girls. So basically, I guess what we could do, or what I would ask the judge to move the court to adopt the main thing I wanted is to adopt these policy limits, and just basically adopt those provisions that I've already said that are set forth in the Rowan contract, and then allow us to put in those good faith dates that we're all kind of in agreement on. If that's everyone's acceptable with that, then I'll put that in there, and make sure that those are the minimums that we can get for coverage. And when they have that, obviously they have to provide proof of coverage before they start, work comp, automobile coverage, liability, somebody on the road delivering product and that kind of stuff. So if we could just have a motion to approve that, that'll give me a baseline on what I can operate on. And if there's anything else that I need to bring to you, I will.
So you want to go ahead and have a motion and a second to adopt, like, the Rowan County contract? To
adopt those limits that were provided in that contract, with the exception of the to-be-determined construction base, with the exception of that. That way, that'll give me, and when I'm discussing it with them, I don't think they'll have a problem with it. This is a big contract, and it's an important contract, and I want to make sure that this body's on board and has a full understanding about what it says if we ever have to go back and rely on. I think that would be appropriate for our needs.
Hey, Sharon, you got anything to add? Rob, me and Clay's been communicating back and forth on it, and obviously he's more knowledgeable about that stuff than I am, but whatever you guys come up with, I'm great with it.
Everything else was in line. I'll say the architect fee was in line with what ours was, so everything is really in line, and I didn't see any problem. They will attach to the contract a certificate of liability insurance, which is basically a declaration sheet providing who they're under, who they're insured by, so things like that. It'd be a reputable insurance company that provides adequate coverage in case of some type of professional negligence or some type of accident or injury. We obviously have coverage, the county does, but we don't want to engage our coverage. We're engaging them to do a service, we're paying them a fee, so we're going to expect that they do what they need to do.
All right, well, we need a motion and a second to adopt into the minutes the same limits of coverage as the Rowan County contract, and for the would-be completion date of the construction project. Jay.
I think the recommendation you made are appropriate.
Okay.
I'll make that motion.
Motion by Brenda. Second by Curtis, all in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you. All right. One thing we have for old business is for the sheriff. We need to approve amended county revenue bond. Need a motion and a second. say that, that we, we've had a little snow event, as everybody knows, and, it's been quite the task to try to get everything done, and, just today, I think we've sort of got caught up. There's gonna be, we're gonna have a couple guys come out again tomorrow, to get some of the roads. Some of these roads, as you all know, it might be 40 in town, but it's still about 28 on some of these back roads. You know, because they're shaded, you know, and covered a lot, so some of it's not coming off real good. But I wanna say thank you to all the farmers and all that, that, I mean, there was a lot of farm, you know, farmers that had these roads scraped by the time we even got there. You know, and it helped out tremendously. And Jason was on his tractor. I think Presto's been out. There's all the magistrates, I think, been out doing something. You know, Brad's been on his bicycle out scraping. but yeah, I've got a picture of it.
That's right.
but I mean, it's just one of those things, and I think it's really well. We had snow routes and stuff with every district. We had a plow in about every district, so it went pretty good. I don't think you all received very many complaints. I don't think. I think Kurt said he got about three. You got four or five.
Yeah,
Jason got a couple. It wasn't too bad, and I think you got a couple too, Brendan. So, but everything went fairly well. I mean, it was. It could have been a whole lot worse. It wasn't a ice storm, by no means.
That's true.
But it was. Yeah, we got ice under it, so that's what made it so much difficult to clean the roads off. It was just terrible. But anyway, Monday we won't think a thing about it. We'll all be gone. But is any of the audience or anything? Anybody got anything? Any kind of statements or anything? We'll go.
I want to say you've done a pretty good job.
I want to thank you guys for doing what y'all did with us.
I want you to do a good job.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And Tommy, I want to thank you too. Tommy actually, he was actually cleaning around his parking lots and stuff, and I seen him, he asked me, and of course we was covered up. Craig was up on the square doing some stuff, and he actually went and cleaned the courthouse parking lot for us so we could have court tomorrow.